Before we start this video, I want to tell y'all that I'm not going to be washing my hair in this video. I'm just going to be explaining the products to y'all. So, just in case you were here for the washing and stuff.
My mania go crazy for the cash. Green Lamborghini paper tag. Riding through the city 30 mags. Niggas snitching, they the police with no badge. How I grew up, my mama with my dad. So when I blew up, I put her in the past. I like to throw it when I think about the crash.
But anyways, what is up and welcome back to my channel. So if anyone is new on here, make sure y'all subscribe. We're on the road to 1k. All right y'all, so in this video I will be telling y'all what I use for my hair and how I, because I've been wearing my hair out curly a lot more. Well, a little bit more. I just washed my hair and decided to start wearing it out, and I realized that what I was using was really good. So I literally like just started this routine, but if anything changes, I will make another video on this, but for right now, this is what's working for me. Also, another side note, whatever I use is not gonna be, may not work for you. So the first thing that I do is I usually have my hair in a bun before I wash my hair. So I just take that down, and in the shower, I use the Strengthen and Restore Shea Moisture. I use this first. It's like, it's really like liquidy. Y'all can see that right there. But I use the shampoo first. Obviously, I only use it for my scalp because that's what shampoo does. It cleans your scalp. So I don't put this, like usually like my last one, I probably go to my ends and use the shampoo. But I don't lather on my ends. That is what the condition, that's where the conditioner comes in. So I have the Strengthen and Restore conditioner. So this is not a liquid product. It's just not liquid. But anyways, but I really love this conditioner because it's just like, it's just good quality and it does my hair good. My ends are always moisturized. My hair smelling good, you feel me? So I love Shea Moisture, and I usually use this. I literally had to go back, like we're almost out of this. So I went back and got more conditioner because we were gone with it. Extra. Anyways, point of the story, point moral of the whole thing that I just said was that I love Shea Moisture. So usually a lot of people actually detangle in the shower, but I usually do like a lot of other stuff in the shower, and that's just too much time, wasting too much water when I could just detangle out of the shower and it can just be way easier. I can just like re-wet it and stuff. But anyways, I always use a wide tooth comb to comb my hair because sis, my hair is not one of those rat tail comb type hair where you can just go gliding through. Sis, look, I know y'all just saw that. No sis, that's not gonna work. Did I just mess my hair up? I don't know. But anyways, so I always use this when I get out the shower. I just part my hair and I use this comb along with the I actually have to get some other detangler. But honestly, any detangler kind of works for me. I just kind of, I had the other, like, Cantu detangler, but that didn't work. Well, it worked, but I was honestly kind of tired of using, like, a creamy detangler, so I wanted a more of a spray kind because I felt like that was just going to be easier than having a whole bunch of cream when I was already putting, like, other types of gels and cream in my hair, so I was like... Anyways, I just picked this one up from the store. It is the Curly Kids Mixed Textured Hair Care. This is literally a kid's detangler, but sis, I mean, I have hair, so might work. But anyways, I use the Super Detangle Spray. This works really good for my hair. As I said, I just like to use a detangler. And I just part that, I comb my hair out, and after I comb my hair out, and I really focus on like the defining and stuff like that when it comes to detangling, because I just want it combed out before I even put anything on it. So the next thing that I use is the Argan Oil, the Sunflower Mega Care Argan Oil. I use this, usually I would kind of like warm it up a little bit. I put it in some hot water while my hair is washing and let it kind of warm up a little bit. I put the hot water in a measuring cup, and then I just put this in the hot water and let it warm up a little bit. But just this past time when I washed my hair, it was actually fine just not being warmed up for me. So I just took this, like I just unhooked it, and after I combed my hair out, I got some of the argan oil and I just put it all over my hair, and just I moisturize them in, sis. These are used for the ends and just for the whole hair, honestly. Honestly, what worked well for me as well, it's the same thing, but it's the castor oil, which worked really good with my hair as well. So the castor oil and the argan oil work good for my hair right after I finished detangling it. The next thing after I use the argan oil or the castor oil, I usually just go in with my Shea Moisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie. And this works really good. I love, like, I don't know, I just like the creaminess, and it just like my hair just defines like so well. After I moisturize it with the argan oil, my hair just starts defining up more, because y'all know like when you comb your hair and it just gets all like not defined sometimes. For some kind of hair, I guess it's just me, but or other people as well, I don't know. But anyways, but for me, you comb your hair out, it's not defined, sis. So after I put the argan oil and stuff on there, I just put this on there and it just helps bring back my curls after the oil, and then this combined starts bringing it back for me. Then after I use the Shea Moisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie, I like to use the Suave Professionals Captivating Curls. It is a mousse, and like, I will show y'all like the texture and how everything looks, but this is really nice. I actually haven't like hadn't been using this for a while, ever since this past weekend when I had just washed my hair and stuff like that, and I just started using this and implementing this like really just more into my routine and seeing how it would work for me, which it worked like really well. Because I'm putting different products in my hair, which works a little bit better than what I was using. So this did help. This does definitely help with my curls and defining it and all that good stuff. After I use the mousse, is this spilling? Oh my, y'all, it's spilling. But anyways, I'm about to clean it off in a little bit. Is it on my dresser? Oh my gosh, it's on my dresser. But anyways, so after I use the mousse, I use the Mixed Chicks. I use the Mixed Chicks Curl Sculptor. And like with this, when I was at the store, I was about to pick up the Miss Jessie's. And I actually think that I'm going to be picking up that soon when I go back to the store. And I really wanted to try that, but I was like, because it is kind of expensive. It's kind of more than the expensive side. So I just saw the Mixed Chicks one, and I was like, let me just try this one out and see how it works for my hair. And it does work a little bit for my hair. Honestly, it is just like really lightweight. Like, it helps my hair. It's just extremely lightweight, and for me, when I want like my gels and stuff, I kind of want them to be a little bit more. It's just like more of like a runny type of gel, but it does help define my curls after I use my other products, which is nice, sis, I tell you. And after I finish putting all my products into that one section, I will maybe sometimes, if I'm, you know, want to, I will try and put the Eco Styling Gel, the Gold Gel. Honestly, I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about this gel really quickly, because I don't know, I don't really use it that much. Like, I've had this for a while, and I'm going to show y'all if I can get it open. Is that even the, oh, it is, okay. I have this much in here, but I usually only use these when I do my hair. So after I put all my products in, I usually braid my hair up. I usually do braid outs or twist outs on my hair, just because for my hair, it just works better. I can't just put, because I always do my hair at night. Usually in the morning, like, I have stuff to do later on that day, and I kind of just don't want Like I usually just don't have enough time because my day going on with my day, and I don't like to get up early when I don't have to, because I always do my hair like on the weekends and stuff, when I don't want to get up all early and do all that when I could just do it at night when I'm already up, awake, in the mood. So yeah, usually I will put this in after I put in my other products, just to kind of like define it a little bit, so that when I actually take it out the next morning or a couple of mornings after, depending if we have to go somewhere that day. But yeah, I will sometimes use this, but just this like just this past weekend when I washed my hair, I didn't use this because I don't know, I just haven't been using this as much as I want to. But it's honestly not my favorite. It's just like really just kind of light, and I like my eco gels to be kind of like a little bit better, but this is okay honestly for my hair. For y'all hair it might work best, but no. Or sometimes I may use my favorite eco, like I had this small one for a while, but sis, I have been stretching it. Look at that. Look, I still have a whole bunch of gel in here. But I have been making this stretch. I love this gel so much. Usually in some of my braid outs or twist outs when I do it at night, I will sometimes put this in here, but usually recently I haven't been putting as much, or even just putting eco gel in my hair at all, just because in the morning my hair just becomes like really like just more, my hair is more shrinked and it doesn't look good. I like the more kind of like stretched out and not shrinking extra stuff, because it's already, my hair's already curly as it is, and I don't want it to be extra shrunken up and stuff like that. So yeah, so then now on to my edges part. Actually, when I do my hair, before I start braiding it up, or when I start getting to that part, I usually make whatever part, either on the left side, I usually have a part on my left side, it's y'all right but my left, and I don't usually do my right side. Sometimes if I'm feeling, you know, a little spicy, I may will. It's, I have a big behind forehead, so sis, the middle part, I don't know. But actually when I had got my hair straightened recently, I had got a middle part, which I actually liked. But my next wash day this weekend, I might actually try a middle part. I don't know, depends on how I'm feeling. But but yeah, onto my edges. Anyways, I do my edges in the morning after I do my hair. So I use, as again, the crystal. This is the, yeah, this is Eco Style Crystal. And I use this on my hair. When I do side stuff like this, I use my handy dandy toothbrush, sis. And Gorilla Snot. Gorilla Snot is my best friend, I'm telling you. So I usually use a mixture of these two for my edges, just so that, you know, they can hold all day. I just, you know, do them. And as I said, if y'all want me to do a video on actually using all these products on my hair and showing y'all the end result, this is a few days after. This is actually day four hair. So I usually kind of wash my hair on the weekends, like once a week. On the weekends preferably. But anyways, so I use these. I always put this one first, and I just put it on my hair. Always wet my toothbrush first. I use this and I just kind of just go with the flows of my edges, whatever kind of edges I'm feeling. And then I will put the Gorilla Snot on top of it, just a little bit. I don't want to do too much because I don't want to start flaking or anything like that. And usually on the other side of my hair. Also then usually on the other side of my hair, I will just use some more of the gel and just kind of just swoop it back a little bit, you feel me? And you know, cause my hair be like, you know, flying up and stuff throughout the day, either the wind, going outside, you feel me? And we just can't just be like, whoa girl, you know, your hair look cute, but sis, you need to fix up front, you feel me? So I try and get that together. But then, as I said, I do my edges in the morning. Usually after I finish braiding everything up, I usually just put my my plastic cap on top of my head. And then I put my bonnet on top of it, my scarf, aka bonnet, you feel me, on my silk pillowcase. This one, it's gonna be on the screen where everything is from, hopefully, if I do that in this video. But yeah, and this honestly helps so much. Like, I had been wanting a pillowcase for so long, and when I had got my curl sculptor, my Mix Chicks hair product, we had went that day and got a silk pillowcase, sis. I was so happy. But there are also more silkier pillowcases, I guess, in like some hair stores and stuff like that. But yeah, in the mornings, after I take my scarf off and stuff, my hair is still usually a little bit wet, but that's fine because I like to use my plastic cap anyway. I use it so that it can retain the moisture and everything. I don't like it to just go dry. My hair will just go too dry just putting a bonnet on my head and just sleeping on my pillow. And no. So I gotta retain that moisture, all that work that I just did for hours sitting there doing my hair, all for it to just be super dry and non-defined in the morning. So then usually the next day after, when I take them out, that's when I said I do my edges and stuff like that. So when it has that wet look, that beautiful wet look. And so usually I don't need it the day after I wash, usually the second or third or fourth day, like now. Every morning, like before I go to school and stuff throughout the week, I will refresh my hair by using the Herbal Essence conditioner. And I will use this and a water bottle with warm water. I put hot water in here, and then I put a little bit of cold water in here, kind of just to even it out. I don't want it too hot to where I spray it on my hand. It's like, ooh, that kind of burned a little bit, you feel me? So yeah, then I mix this with conditioner inside. I shake it up a little bit. Some of it is actually in there now. Like, I don't know if y'all can see it, but y'all can see it, whatever, I'm retarded. But this, I need to get a new water bottle. It is busting in. This is sad, I'm sorry. Go back over my edges a bit more every day in the morning and stuff like that, because you know, your edges be all ugly. And also at night, I will put my hair up in a pineapple. I will use like these little headband thingies. I don't know where you can find them. You can probably find them at stuff like Walmart and stuff like that. I don't know, but or I will get this. I actually got this as a gift for one of my one of the clubs that I'm in school. So they just gave us this. It's supposed to be like a tube top hair thing, all of that together, but I use this for my hair. And or usually just like an old headband or something like that, and just put my hair up in a pineapple. Pineapple is just your hair in a high poof, basically, on top of your head, in case you didn't know. And usually just to keep my curls kind of looking good, I don't just put it on there and then just go to sleep on my silk pillowcase. Usually if it's probably a bit more silkier than the one that I have, then I'll probably be fine. But usually for the ends of my hair up here, if my hair's still like wet and stuff, usually like the day after or a couple days after, if it's still wet and I kind of want to keep that look, then I will just put this on the ends of my hair while I sleep, and then go to sleep on the pillowcase. So then when I wake up, my curls still look good up here. So then all I have to do is just spray it and do my edges again, and then I should be good. I always try and focus on the back as well, because sis, you know, like, I don't even know how that look. And yeah, you know what, let's actually see how this hair look right now in the back, because I don't know. Yeah, probably dry, stiff, everything. Yeah, I know. My camera is about to die, but I just wanted to tell y'all, just in case y'all were wondering, with my hair, when I do dry my hair, even when I get out the shower and stuff like that, I just use a regular cotton towel. It's probably terrible, but I just use that. I don't really have an old t-shirt, but I do have one in here that I could use for my hair, but I rarely use that. I should start doing that more. As that was pretty much my curly hair routine. If I did leave anything out, which I hope I didn't, make sure y'all leave me some comments. Leave me some, you know, comments down below. Let me know what I missed and what y'all want questions on. I will definitely be doing a video if I do have enough questions, so I can answer everything. Also, y'all can DM me or whatever, and I will answer some questions. Any video ideas that y'all have for me, make sure to let me know as well. Make sure to subscribe, as I said, on the way to 1K, you feel me? And make sure to please like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. Make sure to follow all my social medias down below. All of the products will also be down below, just in case, you know, the products and their prices and stuff like that. Maybe where I got them, I may put that in there as well. But make sure to go check out my other videos. Make sure to check out my vlog channel. First link in the description box as well. I do make vlogs. I will be doing another video soon because I get my braces off next Wednesday. So I've had them on for almost 2 years. But anyways, I will let y'all know more about that in another video. Thank y'all so much for watching. And I will see y'all in another video. Bye.
Prepare for light speed. On the spaceship, now I'm a space cadet. Big white legend in my habitat. Aim right at stage like a laser tag.